The scapula has a triangular shape. It lies behind the chest wall. It covers the posterior parts of the 2nd to 7th ribs. It has superior border. Lateral border. And medial border. Which come with inferior angle. Superior angle and lateral angle. Remarkable projections of the scapula are the spine, the acromion, and the coracoid process. The ventral surface, or costal surface, faces the chest wall. Most of the ventral surface is occupied by the subscapular fossa, which is for the subscapularis muscle. The dorsal surface is divided into two parts by the spine of the scapula. The supraspinous fossa is above and smaller. The infraspinous fossa is below and larger. They are confluent at the spinoglenoid notch, which is lateral to the spine. The superior border is thin, sharp and shorter than the other borders. The suprascapular notch is at the medial end of the superior border. The notch is bridged by the superior transverse ligament. This ligament is sometimes ossified, so that the notch becomes the suprascapular foramen. The lateral border is from the inferior angle to the glenoid fossa. The upper end of the lateral border is the infraglenoid tubercle. The inferior angle lies over the 7th rib. The superior angle lies over the 2nd rib. The lateral angle comprises the glenoid fossa and scapular neck. The glenoid fossa has the supraglenoid tubercle at its superior margin. The neck is the region between the infraglenoid tubercle and supraglenoid tubercle. The spine of the scapula is triangular in shape. From its lateral end, the acromion projects forwards. The dorsal surface of the acromion is subcutaneous, so that you can feel it over your shoulder. The coracoid process arises from the neck. It projects forwards and laterally.